All right, just gonna do a video warning about common, very popular trend of movies about and books about science fiction, the occultism and sorcery and voodoo of science fiction. I'm gonna show this very interesting article from David Cloud's website on wavelife.org. Don't agree with David Cloud and everything, you know. I'd have some minor disagreements on some issues, doctrinal issues, but this article on science fiction is very interesting and very telling and shows the dangers of science fiction, the occultism and dangers of science fiction. So I'm going to read this article from David Cloud's website, just showing the dangers and risks and occultism and also evolutionary thought that is prevalent in science fiction. Because science fiction is just simply trying to push out evolution, the false science of evolution, as entertainment, essentially. That's all it is. So let's get into the article. There is an immediate connection between evolution and science fiction, which is not surprising since both deal with the world without God. Oh, there might be a God, a force, but it is definitely not the God of the Bible. The prominent names of science fiction are atheists. Many of them were also prominent in the field of Darwinian science. Now, the force may sound familiar, because where does it come from? Star Wars. Star Wars is probably one of the most popular science fiction movies, probably like universally known in the world. I mean, Star Wars, I mean, you ask any person in Europe or America, have you heard of Star Wars? If they tell you no, they're probably living under a rock, because everyone's heard of Star Wars. It's become a pop culture icon. That's what Star Wars has. And they substitute God for the Force in that film. It's science fiction, it's Eastern mysticism and occultism under the guise of entertainment. Take Carl Sagan, 1934 to 1996, for example, whose best-selling sci-fi novel Contact was made into a movie. Sagan was one of the high priests of atheistic evolution. In his novel, he has the main character debating two preachers, saying, quote, "There is no compelling evidence that God exists," unquote. Not long before he died, Sagan said, quote, "I share the view of a hero of mine, Albert Einstein. I cannot conceive of a God who rewards and punishes his creatures or has a will of the kind that we experience in ourselves. Neither can I, nor would I want to, conceive of an individual that survives his physical health. Let feeble souls from fear or absurd egotism cherish such thoughts." That's prayed March 10th, 1996. So that's what he had to say about God, this popular sci-fi author. That's what he had to say about God. He was an atheist sorcerer, an atheist. You know, I'm a former atheist, by the way. I thought I'd just throw it out there. Atheists don't like it when I point that out, but I'm actually a former atheist, and this kind of stuff is the mindset of atheists. That was my mindset when I was an atheist. Plain and simple. Let's continue, make sure I'm full screen. Yeah. Consider another prominent name in sci-fi, Isaac Asimov, 1920 to 1992. In a 1982 interview, he said, "Emotionally, I am an atheist. I do not have the evidence to prove that God doesn't exist, but I so strongly suspect that he doesn't, and I don't want to waste my time." That was an interview with Isaac Asimov. I can't say his. Sorry, I'm just not good at pronouncing some of these names. On a Science and Bible, Free Inquiry, Spring 1982, page 9. So he says, "Well, I don't know if God exists, but I want to think he doesn't exist." So you're not so sure there, are you? See, most atheists, I believe that most atheists know deep down inside there is a God. They just don't want to admit it. They're in self-denial. That's, you know, when I was an atheist, I wanted to deny God, but deep down inside, I knew there definitely was a creator out there. I was just self-denial. And, you know, when I became a false convert, I was a religious atheist. You can see my testimony about the whole issue. Consider Robert Heinlein, hope I'm saying that name right, 1907 to 1988, called, quote, "the dean of science fiction writers." He rejected the Bible and promoted free sex, fornication, essentially. His book, Stranger in a Strange Land, is considered, quote, "the unofficial Bible of the hippie movement." Heinlein was a nudist and practiced polyamory. He promoted agnosticism in his sci-fi books. So he was a pervert, essentially. He was a polyamorist, which means he had multiple partners, and he was a nudist. He was a stinking pervert, which is what a lot of these atheist writers are, essentially. As a lot of them are, and they're pushing perversion like no other author or no other activist ever would. Consider Arthur Clarke, 1917 to 2008, author of many sci-fi works, including 2001, A Space Odyssey. Clarke promoted evolutionary pantheism. He told Sri Lankan newspaper, "I don't believe in God or an afterlife." That was from Life Beyond 2001, exclusive interview with Arthur C. Clarke, The Island, December 20th, 2000. In the instructions he left for his funeral in March 2008, he said, "Absolutely no religious rites of any kind relating to any religious faith should be associated with my funeral." So he was a God hater too. He hated God. He was just another atheist who just hated God, just like I was when I was an atheist, plain and simple. Because most atheists, they hate God. They can say they don't believe in God. The way they act and the way they speak about God, they obviously believe there is a God and they just don't like him, which is what I was when I was an atheist. Consider Kurt Vonnegut, hope I'm saying that name right. He was an atheist and was an honorary president of the American Humanist Association. He subscribed to its code, which, quote, does not accept supernatural views of reality. Then you got Gene Roddenberry, creator of Star Trek. He was an agnostic and humanist who envisioned a world in which everyone is an atheist and better for it. That was in an interview at the International Atheist Conference, June 24, 2006. Consider H.G. Wells, author of the science fiction classics The Time Machine, War of the Worlds, and The First Man on the Moon. He converted to Darwinianism as a college student under the influence of Thomas Huxley. He was essentially a fundamentalist for Darwinianism. He was referred to as Darwin's bulldog, and spent the rest of his life preaching atheism and extreme forms of eugenics. So he was a eugenicist and an atheist too, who did all this kind of stuff, and they have a lot of stuff on him on in the article down there. But there's many, many others that he gives an example of. Ray Bradbury, again, I'm not good at saying some of these names. Terry Pratchett, again, suck at pronouncing these names. Thomas Ditch, and just a bunch of others. They list other authors down there, just showing the examples of the occultism and atheism and evolutionary false science and mysticism that comes with science fiction. So just a little warning about science fiction out there. It is essentially tied in with the occult and tied in because evolution goes hand in hand with the occult. Don't kid me. It goes hand in hand with the occult. It is a religious belief. Evolutionists, hardcore evolutionists and Darwinianists, they have a religious fervor to them. Plain and simple. They are fundamentalists for atheism and Darwinism. So just giving a warning about the mysticism and occultism and atheist false science that is prevalent in science fiction. So just beware of science fiction. Anyway, may the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ be with all the brethren. Goodbye. Thank you.